Bismillah, Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. Dear friends, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your siyam and qiyam. Our woman for today is Khawla bintu Thalaba. As I have said many, many times, Islam, when it touches individuals, males and females, and children, it reached them to high levels of morality, akhlaq, etiquette, adab, and makes giants of them. How many billions of human beings lived and passed and nobody remembered them? And here we are, people of the 6th, 7th century, very primitive, even in the cities and outside the cities more primitive, when they were touched by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when they were touched by the Quran and the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they molded their lives according to the Quran and the teaching of the Prophet, they became immortal. Here we are after 14, 45 years talking about them and about their stories. It's amazing. And this is not only that generation. All the way till nowadays, how many millions of people who passed and came and gone, those few who accepted Islam after they've been touched, they became giants. Like Muhammad Asad, who was Leopold Weiss from Kiev, from Ukraine. When he became a Muslim, he became a giant. And many, many others here in the States, like Estes and like Hamza Yusuf and many others, like Muhammad Ali, like you name it, many, many of them, they became giants. This is a phenomenon that needs to be studied. So Khawla was nobody, but when she was touched by Islam and the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, God himself addressed her and addressed her complaint and her issues. So what happened with Khawla bint Thalaba? And she is from the Ansar, and this is different from Khawla bint al-Hakim al-Sulamiyya. Her husband is Aws ibn al-Samit, an older man. He is the brother of Ubadah ibn al-Samit, a great Sahabi with a lot of narration of the Hadith and so on. He apparently was angry with her, and he has done something in the Jahiliyyah they used to do. She is his wife, but he tell her, "You are like my mother," so he wouldn't touch her. And this is al-dhihar. He said, "Anti alayya ka dhahri ummi." So it's a kind of divorce, but not divorce. She stays at home. And she went to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and complained. And the answer came from heaven. What should be done? Number one, this is wrong. And your mother is the one who put birth to you or nursed you. Wet mother, and uttering these words doesn't make it right, or doesn't make it true or right, and he needs to do few things: to free a slave, or fast 2 months, or feed 60 poor people, and that habit been abolished, and ever since. So this is the story of Khawla, who later on stopped Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anh in the market and gave him an advice. May God bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.